Hello students. So already I discussed with relational algebra operations and calculus operations in our previous classes. So here we have a chapter outline, so which already I think we have dealt with. So we have already studied relational algebra, so where we have looked into unary relational operations. Then we have binary relational operations. So in unary relational operations, we have seen select operation, and we have seen project operation, and we have seen rename operation. So unary means these operations work with single table. So on binary relations, these are from set theory. So the binary operations work with two tables, that is union, where you can combine two similar tables, where it is a union operation, it could be intersection operation, or it could be set difference, that is minus operation. But here one condition with respect to these operations to be performed are is type compatibility. So type compatibility defines that both the tables with respect to number of attributes, with the domains of the attributes, both should be same. So this is also a kind of binary only, but these operations work on two tables where it is both the tables should be type compatible. So already we have seen these operations on different tables, and suppose there are tables where type compatibility is not there, then how to combine these two tables? So what is the relational algebra that we can use on these two tables? So they are like joining tables. So we can join the tables in various ways. So one is Cartesian product, that is a cross product, and another is a filtered form of Cartesian product is join operation. So in join operation, we need to write the join condition. So you may see here there is a join condition in this case. So you may see there is a join condition. So this join condition depends on what condition you want to join the two different tables. So in this case, you may have equijoin or natural join, or many other types of joins are available with you. So actually already we have discussed all these things in our regular classes. Now we have just left with one more operation, that is division operation. So in the division operation, this is applied on two tables, two different tables. So where we generally, the example is given here, you may see the definition here. So the definition says that there are two relations R and S with Z attribute and S attribute. So Z attribute and X, these are two sets of attributes, where you may see that the X attributes are subset of Z, and the resultant table will contain Y attributes, which is Z minus X. That means it will contain the attributes other than X, but they should be there in Z. And the result of the division, that is the relation, it is again a new relation what we have called as TY. So it will include the tuples T that happens along with, it should be there in the S, but the same set should also happen in R. So let us take one example here. So through that example, we'll try to understand how this is going to work. Now you may see here, this is, there are two tables are here. So here there are two tables. The first table is R, the second table is S. Now we see this R table contains ESSN and P numbers, the list of ESSN and P numbers. And the second table contains some examples now, P number, so which contains 10 and 30. So these two values are there. Now what is the result of this after doing the division? So suppose if I say R division S, suppose I say R division S, so you may see here this is R division S. If I do R division S, then what is the resultant table will have? Now the resultant table will have what? The first table contains ESSN and P number. and the second table contains only the P number. So what is the remaining one? Remaining is ESSN. So this will go as a attribute for the resultant table T. That is, the T will be the resultant table. So this T contains what? ESSN. And what is the output that it contains? Now let us check what is the output that the rows it contains. Now there are 10 and 30. Now what you should check in this R table, wherever this 10 and 30 occurs, these two values should occur together in this table, that is in R table, along with the same value of ESSN should appear in front of these two values. Presently it is containing two values. So in this case, suppose if we check, so this example, in this case 10, so there is a ESSN that is 333445. So this is in front of 10. Then there is 20, the same value happens, but 20 is not there in this, so we have to skip it up. Let us come to 30 here. So 30 is taking 99848 47s, and 10 is also taking how much? 99848 47s. So 10 and 30, see, if we observe this place, so 10 and 30 are containing the same ESSN. So this will go as our result. So we may observe, so this result will come here. This row has appeared in this. Similarly, let us check, is there any ESSN? The ESSN should be same for both 10 and 30. Now if I come here, yeah, there's one more value. 10 contains 98798787, and 30 also contains the same value. So if you observe these rows, you may have the same value, so which has come here. So this is our second result. So this is how the division operation takes place. Let us check with one more example here. If I take 1, 2 and 3, suppose it contains 1, 2, 3. Now when I come to this table, now the resultant table will be having again ESSN. Now what are the values in this case? Now let me remove this. These are of previous example. So I have removed it. Now this is an empty table. Now let us go and check it out with 1, 2, 3. What is the output you should check for? Now the ESSN should be same for all 1, 2, 3. Now 1. Okay, now this contains 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 2 also contains the same value. But whereas if 3 would have contained the same value, then this would have been the output. But here in this present example, it contains a different value. Let me check, is there any 3 containing same value as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9? So 3 contains some different value, so this is not going to occur. Similarly, check for 1, 2. See, 1 and 2 contain same values, but whereas 3 is containing a different value. Suppose 2, 3 contains this. If 1 contains this same value as 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, then this could be the output. But in this present example, 1, 2, 3 doesn't contain the same ESSN anywhere throughout this table. So we'll be having an empty set. So this will be an empty set. Let us check with some other example. In this case, suppose this contains, assume, okay, now we'll have only 1, 2. What will be the output of this? Suppose it contains only 1, 2. Now let us check here, 1, 2 is this. So now this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 is one of the outputs. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 is one of the outputs. Let us check whether the same ESSN happens with 1, 2. So now this one, 4, 5, let us check. Yes, there is one more example, that is 4, 5. So we have got this example here, 4, 5, this 3, 4, 5, 3, 4, 5, 3. This is one more output. Let us check, is there 1, 2 containing the same value? So I think this were 1, 2, 1, 2. Okay, so these two rows come as the output. So hope you have understood. Similarly, let me check one more example here. So okay, now this is a table 1, so which contains roll number and sports. So there are 4 students playing different sports. This is one table. Second table, it contains only the sports details. For example, badminton and cricket. Now if we do a table 1 division with table 2 division, that is table 1 division, table 2. Now what are the attributes table 1 contains? Roll number and sports. What are the table 2 contains? Only sports.